I'm gonna call on some people if I don't get volunteers. And I may call anyway, just to see if you're listening and paying attention. Without looking at your notes, who can tell me all five? Josh?
Opposite sides parallel, opposite sides angles.
Opposite angles what? Okay, what's the other opposite?
Opposite sides are congruent.
Okay.
Diagonal bisects, bisect.
Each other?
Yeah, and consecutive angles.
Or supplementary. Okay, good. All right, how about you, Joe?
Opposites are equal, opposite angles are equal, consecutive equals 180, diagonal bisects.
There's one more opposite. Opposite sides are parallel. And that's important for alternating interior angles as well. How about you, William? Give me the three opposites. Come on now, you gotta listen. Michael, do you know the three opposites? You can't tell me one of them?
Reading at it.
Okay, that's honest. How about you, Miss McKenzie? That's one. What else? Are you looking?
I have it written down.
All right, I want to know if you got it right here. Who else thinks they know at least four out of the five, or all five? Birthday girl? How about you, Brandon?
Other than size, what do shapes have?
All right, here we go.
Angles.
Look up here.
Everybody's got an answer. That was right. What are they? Angle, opposite angles, what?
All right, opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are congruent. And opposite angles are congruent. Sides are parallel. Sides are congruent, and opposite angles are congruent. Then you have diagonals bisect each other. And then you have consecutive angles add up to 180. So those two are consecutive, they add up to 180. These two are consecutive, they add up to 180. That's all it is. All right, let's talk about these problems here. This one right here, Devin, these are opposite angles. So they're equal because of that symbol. Let me make this clear. That symbol means that all five of these properties apply. So you better know that, okay? All right, so 2a plus 30 is equal to 4a minus 4. Subtract 2a. From both sides. So that gives me 30 is equal to 2a minus 4. Now I'm going to add 4. To both sides, so I get 34, and then I divide and get 17. So if I want to know the angle, I got to substitute 2 times 17 plus 30. Any questions on how to get A? Opposite angles are equal. All right, next, opposite sides are equal. So x plus 2 is equal to 2x minus 20. I mean, it's really not hard. We're just going to do this today as well. So I'm going to add and get 22. If I want to know the side, I plug it in. 22 plus 2 is 24. Any questions on the bell work? The tests have been graded and recorded. You'll get it the last 5 minutes. But I graded it and counted it as a homework grade, so it wouldn't hurt some of you. We're going to reteach it and test you again down the road. All right, today's the last day to turn in any work that you didn't turn in from last week that I picked up. Put away your bell work, please. Try to do number 3 or example 3. Diagonals bisect each other. Write an equation. First, draw the diagram. Remember, diagonals bisect each other. Draw the diagram and put what pieces are equal. Stay on the same line, okay? Don't jump from one line to the other line because you'll miss it. Stay on the same line. Which pieces are equal? Write an equation. In fact, write two equations. You might have to use substitution method or elimination. Work deep. Come on. This one is equal to that one. Write two equations. Follow the line and write two equations. I don't know if you're able to work it. I'm going to show you. Maybe you can, but the equations are going to be, and again, follow the line. It's going to be 3y minus 7 is equal to this bottom piece. Stay on the same line. So 3y minus 7 is equal to 2x. The other equation is going to follow this line. It's going to be x plus 1 equals y. Any questions about where I got these two equations from? Now watch this. You see how y is by itself? Circle this and put substitution. You were taught the substitution method. And just like the quadratic equation, you need to know the substitution method. So we're going to substitute all of this in place of that y right there. So instead of 3y, we're going to have 3 times the substitute is equal to, or minus 7, is equal to 2x. Again, instead of that y, we're substituting. Now, I don't know who tried to teach you substitution method, but you need to know it. So copy this down. You can watch the video. I guess there'll be some problems like this. So here we go. What is 3 times x? 3x. What is 3 times 1? See if you can work the rest of it before I do. Combine like terms and try and work it. We need to know what x is. Once we find x, we'll find y after that. Again, this is the substitution method. You need to know how to do this. Does anybody have X? Anybody? Go ahead, Tori.
I have 4.
All right, she said 4. I don't know if it's right. Anybody else got 4? All right, a few people. Anybody got anything different? All right, here I go. Let me check it. Do I have more pluses or more minuses? How many more minuses? I have x's on both sides. I go after the smaller one. Some of you, for some reason, don't want to put 0. I don't know what's the deal with that, but hey, this is 0. And that gives me x minus 4. So now I'm going to add 4. So x is 4. Now, if you did it a little differently, I don't care, as long as you got 4. Now, let's go back to y. Y is right here. What does x equal? So put a 4 right here. What's 4 plus 1? 5. Does everybody see that? This is called substitution. You got to know how to do it. All right, so then you just come back up here. X was 4, so 4 plus 1 is 5. So this piece on your test is 5, and so is the other piece because they bisect. Bisect means perfectly in half. Any questions on how to do this problem? All right, the last one. It'll be on video. You should watch it. Copy down this theorem and draw this problem, please. It says if parallel lines cut off congruent segments on one transversal, then they cut off congruent segments on all transversals. Copy down that theorem and draw the diagram. parallel lines cut off congruent segments on one, then it cuts off congruent segments on all transversal. This one has four parallel lines and two transversal.
The other kids are doing it. You need to do it too, so. You don't want to do it. They don't want to do it either.
All right, here we go. If you're not done copying, I want you to watch, okay? So just stop. Here are my parallel lines. One, two, three, four. Here's a transversal, and these are equal. Since these are equal, these are going to be equal. Now, I'm not saying they're the same. I'm saying this piece is equal to that piece is equal to that piece. So look at the question. EH is this whole thing. If this piece is 4, then this is 4, and this is 4. So that's 4, 8, 12. So the answer should be 12. It's not hard. It's real easy. Again, the theorem says, if parallel lines cut congruent segments in one transversal, then it must cut congruent segments in the other transversal. It's not saying that this one is equal to that one. It's saying that these pieces are equal. So 4, 8, 12. Any questions on how to do today's work? All right, there was one bell work that I didn't go over, but I wanted to. But we're going to go ahead and get started so I don't eat up all your time. So copy this down. This is in the workbook today. I think I already put it in the computer. I'll check. This video will be uploaded.